the day by saying Jai Hind. Good morning to one and all present here. Today, we all are here to celebrate India's 75th Independence Day. This occasion marks the patriotic spirit within us and encourages us to be loyal and respectful towards our nation. Now, before we proceed with today's function, I would like to introduce you all to the chief guest of today, Chief Petty Officer of the Indian Navy, Mr. Birendranath Ghosh. He has served in the Indian Navy for 28 years. He has been serving on the boat ship for 13 years, and not to forget, the Sea Cadet Corps instructor at the Good Shepherd International School. We will now commence the ceremony with the hoisting of the national flag by our chief guest, Chief Petty Officer, Mr. Birendranath Ghosh. Everyone is requested to stand to attention, which will then be followed by the national anthem. Everyone is requested to remain standing as Ms. Amy Amrish Patel from Grade 5 will lead us in prayer.
Join your hands, close your eyes, and please bow your heads. Let us pray. O dear Good Shepherd, make our school a home away from our home. Make us always feel that we all belong to a family and that the teachers are like our parents. We believe that you speak through them when we listen to them. Give more wisdom to all concerned with us, so that they may guide us always on the right path. Make us know your presence and power by rewarding and punishing us. Let us not become proud when we are rewarded, and let us not become humiliated when you punish us for our mistakes. Give us enough strength to forget and forgive as you forgive us our sins. We thank you for the showers of blessings on this school, for its growth and progress into a big and good school. Give us everything to make our lives in this school a happy one. This we ask for your love's sake. Amen.
Thank you, Amy. Now, I would like to call upon the students who will be presenting a patriotic dance which is choreographed by our very own Ms. Rama Madhu and our students.
Good morning. Our sports persons, with their hard work and dedication, brought laurels to our country and made us all very proud. Our dance club at Good Shepherd International School has decided to celebrate our 75th Independence Day by paying a tribute to all our Olympic heroes and champions and to all the sportspersons of the country. Hope you enjoy the dance and wishing you all a very happy Independence Day. Namaste.
पढ़ करने वो करके हम दिखलाएंगे, जीत की बाजी खेले हम और दिल को भी जीत के आएंगे। Up, we're born to win. We never stop. Say,
hey, 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 hey,
hey, hey, Hindustani, hey, har pal har dil ye gaaye.
Dance is the hidden language of the soul, and the energy I witnessed here proved it right away. Next, I would like to call upon Ms. Zara Elizabeth Kurian of Grade 7 to deliver the Independence Day speech.
Good morning to one and all present here. Today, India is celebrating its 75th Independence Day. This day teaches us the importance of patriotism and strengthens our unity. Today, we are fortunate that we are raised in an amazing independent country. We thank our brave soldiers who fearlessly safeguard our borders to protect us and have devoted their life for the independence of our country. We take this opportunity to remember those who have sacrificed themselves at the border in the last 74 years to keep the nation independent and safe. Recently, 20 of our Jawans lost their lives at the India-China border. On this occasion, our thoughts turn first to the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, the man behind our struggle for freedom and who sought liberty from both foreign rule and the native social chains that had imprisoned our society. The years 2020 and 2021 has taught us many tough lessons. Through the years, we have been knowingly or unknowingly destroying nature and have considered ourselves as supreme. However, the COVID pandemic has demolished the illusion that human beings are the master of nature. I believe it is still not too late for humanity to correct its course and live in harmony with nature, since nature has been ever forgiving and heals itself. This virus does not recognize any artificial divisions created by human society. This reinforces the belief that we need to rise above all man-made differences, prejudices, and barriers. Compassion and mutual help have been adopted as basic values by the people in India. We need to further strengthen this virtue in our conduct. Only then can we create a better future for all of us. The younger generation has learned the lessons well, and I believe that the future of India is safe in their hands. These are difficult times for all of us, more so for our youth. The closure of our educational institutions would have caused anxiety among our girls and boys, casting a shadow over their dreams and aspirations for the time being. However, I would like them to know that this difficult period is only a temporary phase and they should not give up working for their dreams. Let us look on the brighter side. While we celebrate this day by showing gratitude and being proud of how much India has developed, we also applaud the grit and resilience of the country's frontline workers in the fight against COVID-19, which has killed thousands in the country, and congratulate our Indian contingent at the Tokyo Olympics, who did us proud as this was India's best Olympic performance ever, with 1 gold, 2 silver, and 4 bronze. Neeraj Chopra's gold medal in javelin throw helped in India jump 18 places in the Tokyo Olympics medal tally and has secured the 47th position. Though this year has been an extremely difficult year with the pandemic, pain, isolation, and heartbreaking loss, it has pushed us to have become stronger and have unified us even more. Just to think back where India was 2 years ago and how it has changed since then is quite astonishing. For example, Every day we have to go outside wearing a suffocating mask with the fear of not getting COVID. It has even become extremely dangerous to talk to your close friends. I quote the opening remarks of the Director General of World Health Organization at the Member State briefing on the COVID-19 pandemic evaluation. 9th July, 2020. My hope is that the defining crisis of our age will likewise remind all people that the best way forward and the only way forward is together. These are the basics, but the time-tested truth. Together is the solution unless you want to give the advantage to the enemy, to the virus that has taken the world hostage, and this has to stop. I end quote. It is democracy that gives us the right to live freely as proud citizens of our country. For democracy to flourish, we should all first be together as one to confront this deadly disease and to make it through this difficult period. Because no matter whatever happens around you, there is always light at the end of the tunnel. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Zara. I would like to call upon the Indian Music Choir, who will be performing a patriotic song, Vande Mataram. And the future is yet to come. So let's discover the power of now. I would like to thank the choir for spreading the valuable message with the heart-rendering melody. I would now like to call upon Master Kavish Agarwal from grade 9 to deliver his patriotic speech.
A very good morning to Elsie Mamam, our co-founder, Mr. Jacob Thomas, President, Mrs. Sarah Jacob, Senior Vice President, Mrs. Sheila Alexander, Principal, Academic Council members, parents, teachers, and my dear students. Today we are celebrating the 75th Independence Day of India. The day 15th August marks the anniversary of our national independence from the British Empire. It holds an everlasting place in our country's memory and commands the respect of every Indian. This day has become a very important day in Indian history and in the hearts of every Indian, as the entire nation celebrates this day with the full spirit of patriotism. Indian leaders and revolutionaries such as Mahatma Gandhi, Bhagat Singh, Lala Lajpat Rai, Subhash Chandra Bose, Sarojini Naidu, and Jawaharlal Nehru, and many more, took part in the freedom struggle against the British over a long period of time. But most notable of the early rebellions was the Indian Rebellion of 1857, and this ultimately led to India's freedom of the Indian Independence Act 1947, which transferred legislative sovereignty. The Indian Constituent Assembly came in effect on August 15, 1947. The day also coincides with the partition of British-ruled India into two countries, India and Pakistan. On this auspicious day, the country's brothers shed their blood, died with pride during war, courageously protested against the British imperial rule, just to ensure that the generations after theirs prosper and have a secure future ahead. After centuries of struggle, pain, sacrifices, discrimination, and inequality, India eventually broke the chains that held them as slaves to the British, and with unity, they bought peace, happiness, and prosperity. As the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, fasted in Calcutta He is believed to have spent his time praying, fasting, spinning, and silently protesting the hatred that had taken over the country. Jawaharlal Nehru has also given a speech on Independence Day. He said, I quote, "At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom. A moment comes, which comes but rarely in history, when we step out of the old to new, when an age ends, and when the soul of a nation, long suppressed, finds utterance." I unquote. Similarly, we are also collectively facing the COVID-19 pandemic threat that has created a global health crisis and has a deep impact on our lives. These are difficult times when we must join our hands in common endeavor with a strong belief that better days are ahead of us. Just like how our forefathers fought against British unitedly, we should also fight against the pandemic together. I want to reassure you that if we remain united, resolute, and responsible, then we will be able to overcome anything. Today, countless brave fighters and soldiers are still protecting us from the other nations by putting their lives on the line so that we could be with our families happy and safe. The tradition of celebrating Independence Day is upheld in India so that the young generations are aware of sacrifices once made for this country to make it a better place. Also, the youth is made aware of the developments that had taken place since India got independence. In conclusion, bringing independence to India by freeing it from the British rule was not easy. At 15th August of every year is celebrated to pay respect to the culmination of struggle, hardships and sacrifices made by the Indians to earn this country's freedom. Let's together continue the legacy and make our forefathers proud. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Thank you, Kavish. Now we have another performance by the Indian Music Choir who will be performing the song Khalistan Kyon Mang Rahe Hain.
Khalistan kyon?
I am sure everyone here is enthused with the patriotic spirit. Moving ahead, I would like to call upon Master Harshal Aman from Grade 12 for the welcome note.
Good morning, respected Chief Guest, Mr. Birendra Nath Ghosh, Chief Petty Officer, QA1, Gunners, Honorable Co-Founder, Mrs. Elsma Thomas, President, Mr. Jacob Thomas, Principal, Mrs. Sheila Alexander, Senior Vice President, Mrs. Sarah Jacob, respected coordinators, teachers, parents, and my dear friends. It is a privilege for me to welcome you all to the celebration of our 75th Independence Day. India attained independence on this day 74 years ago, after several years of struggle. The feeling of an identity as Indians is behind many strong emotions. The founding fathers of this nation, along with the numerous freedom fighters who gave their lives for the country, wanted this nation to be independent and prosperous. Over the last 7 decades, India has emerged towards becoming a global power in order to fulfill their dreams. Today, we have with us Mr. Birendra Nath Ghosh, Chief Petty Officer at the Indian Navy. He served the Naval Force for 28 years, during which he spent 13 years serving on the seas. After which, he served as a qualified instructor for 10 years at the prestigious Naval Training Institute. He was later part of the Defense Administration for 5 years and is currently with us at Good Shepherd International School as a Sea Cadet Corps instructor. Mr. Ghosh is specialized in shooting, swimming, and also sails at the national level. Sir has multiple hobbies including squash, badminton, and football. So, you're an example and inspiration to us. Your work ethic and spirit at which you lead us has ignited the spark of patriotism, not only to the students, but the entire community. We are honored to have you with us, sir. India has a lot to offer to the global community, especially for intellectual and spiritual enrichment, promotion of world peace, and aspiring youth in various fields. With this spirit, I once again welcome you all to the celebration of the 75th Independence Day at Good Shepherd International School. I now invite Mr. Birendra Nath Ghosh to speak a few words. Jai Hind, and thank you.
Thank you, Harshal. Now, the wait for the auspicious moment is over. I would like to call upon our chief guest, Chief Petty Officer, Indian Navy, Mr. Birendra Nath Ghosh, to address the gathering.
A very good morning to dear students, parents, and all the staff of Good Shepherd International School family. Today, as you know, our India is celebrating 75th Independence Day. In this COVID pandemic times, it's a pleasure to see the GSIS family standing strong together and celebrating India's 75th Independence Day virtually. I want to convey my heartfelt thanks to Madam, our co-founder, Mrs. Elsma Thomas, President, Mr. Jacob Thomas, Senior Vice Presidents, Students' Welfare, Mr. Sarah Jacob, Principal, Mrs. Sheila Alexander, and the Academic Council members of GSIS family for providing me with this platform to address you all today. Every year on 15th August, Indians all over the world celebrate their country's Independence Day, the day that marks the end of 190 years of British rule in India. On this day in 1947, India was declared a free country after years of struggle. Let's bow our head in thanking and expressing our gratitude to our great freedom fighters for their sacrifices and determination in giving us today's independent India. For any country, its Independence Day is always the most memorable day, not only to rejoice in the glory for what their country has been able to achieve, but also a day to remember the contributions, battles, and sacrifices of all the people who helped achieve it. Indians celebrate this day, taking the opportunity to remember our heroes. Today, India is a very powerful country in the world, in politically, as a defense power, and economically. I don't want to delve deep into Indian politics, but yes, I speak as an ex-Indian Navy person, as one who served in Indian Navy for 28 years. That is from 1984 to 2012. Let me tell you, I was just an 18 years old young man when I joined in the Navy to serve the nation. The day following up my retirement, I joined India's number one educational institution, GSIS, as a Sea Cadet Corps instructor. I am very grateful and I want to salute our late founder, Principal Dr. P.C. Thomas, for giving me this platform to serve this prestigious institution. I remember the day, post of my interview, after settling me, sir told me, many ups and downs will come in your life, but always stay strong, be happy, and be honest. Today, from this platform, I want to give one message to our students, which I have acquired while serving in the Navy and have implemented as well. A saying by John Fisher, earlier British Admiral, which goes like this: hit fast, hit hard, keep on hitting. Let me elaborate this. Hit fast. Do not worry about tomorrow. Be alert in grabbing the right opportunity in your life and strongly stick to your goals. Hit hard. Embed your aim into your goals and keep on trying. Try harder until you reach where you have always dreamt of reaching. Keep on hitting. Each day is a new day, and each learning makes you a better person. So push harder than yesterday if you want a different tomorrow. Dear students, never be afraid of doing and standing up for what's right. While doing so, the path may seem difficult, but it's never impossible. A ship is always safe at the shore, but that's not what it's meant for. A ship is meant to float, to move, and fight. I want to relate this quote with your current student's life. Take up challenges, learn from it, stay focused, and fight every obstacle which comes in between you and your ambitions. And for a ship to sail well, it needs right navigation. In your life, navigation is very important. Now you all must be wondering how to relate navigation and life together. Well, in general terms, taking ships, submarines, aircraft, your car, motorbike from one place to another place in the shortest route, easiest method, and safe direction by a navigator, driver, pilot, etc. is called navigation. Similar to this, your life also needs right navigation along with right navigator. Who is your navigator in your school? Your teachers. I am sure you all will feel extremely proud to have such strong navigators at GSIS as your teachers. It is extremely important to have and choose such path providers, guides, mentors in your life who can make you gain self-confidence, determined, and most importantly, to understand what's evil and what's good. The youth of our country has the power to change the nation. Someone has rightly said that the future hinges onto the young generation. Hence, it becomes your duty to serve the nation and make every possible effort to make our country better. Today, where on the one hand we are joyous about our beloved country's independence, on the other hand, it is of utmost importance that we become and behave like responsible citizens of our nation. A country is made stronger only by its people. We are aware of what kind of difficult times across the globe we are dealing with due to COVID pandemic. It has now become the daily hassle of our life. As you all are the youth, the future of our nation, it's in your hand to spread awareness on safety precautions and prevent situation from getting worse. It can be done by taking some very simple precautions like this: physical distancing, wearing of mask properly, keeping rooms well ventilated, avoid crowds, regularly clean your hands, avoid touching your eyes, nose, mouth, etc. Before I end, I would like to recite one song of our great poet, philosopher, musician, artist, writer, composer, and educationist, Rabindranath Tagore, that comes in my mind. If no one comes when you call, walk alone, walk alone, walk alone, walk alone. If no one comes when you call, walk alone. Freedom in mind, faith in words, pride in your heart, memories in your souls. Let's salute the nation on Happy Independence Day. Thank you all and Jai Hind.
We would like to thank you, sir, as you took the festivity of the event to a greater level by your inspiring speech to us. Finally, I would like to call Master Ara from Grade 12 for the expression of gratitude.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am delighted to be a part of these celebrations on this Red Letter Day. On behalf of the school, I would like to thank the chief guest, retired Chief Petty Officer, Mr. Birendranath Ghosh, for gracing this event with his presence. I would also like to express our sincere gratitude to our co-founder, Mrs. Elsema Thomas, School President, Mr. Jacob Thomas, Senior Vice President, Mrs. Sarah, and our Principal, Mrs. Sheila Alexander, for coordinating and making this entire program possible. We are also very thankful for the support of the IT department, the co-curricular and the administrative staff for their dedicated support, which is instrumental in the smooth running of this program. Finally, my gratitude for all the participants that spoke and entertained us today, and the viewers who have made the program meaningful with their albeit remote presence. To all the school community joining us remotely, we appreciate your wholehearted support and hope to see you all soon. Take care and Jai Hind.
Thank you, Arif. All are requested to please rise for the school anthem.
Thank you.
Today, let us celebrate the freedom to express and live our lives with pride. Let us salute our mother India. May the Indian tricolor always fly high. Be proud to be an Indian. Happy Independence Day and Jai Hind.